Have you tried children? Exercise 4.5, 8th problem, factorize. I hope you have did the problem. If you find little difficult the last one, I will do it once again. So that you can check your answer. Those who not did, observe here, okay? Now, the last one is 27p cube minus 1 by 216 minus 9 by 2 p square plus 1 by 4 p. We have to factorize. That is, they are given a cube minus b cube minus 3a square b plus 3a square ab square. In that format they are given. Now your work is, when you factorize this, with what is the actual the real number we have the thing, the trinomial we have taken, the binomial where it's cube. If you did a plus b cube, that a and b we have to find out, and you have to write in the form of a plus b cube, right? So which one we have to use here? They have given actually the formula which we are making use is a minus b whole cube is equal to a cube minus b cube minus 3ab a minus b. This format they are given, and its next simplified format they are given this answer. So the simplified form is a cube minus b cube minus 3 a into a, 2 times a, so 2 will come, a square b minus minus plus 3 a b into b b square. So they have given the answer in this format, in this format. So your work is to find a minus b cube, how much, which cube if you do, you will get this answer. You have to find that, the reverse process is called factorize. So a and b we have to find out. So this is the format they are given. So I will write the think now, given problem in this way. It is 27 p cube minus 1 by 216 minus 9 by 2 p square plus 1 by 4 p. So they are given in this format. Now I will try to write in the cube form. It should be written in the cube form. A cube. Or I will write like this way. Then I'll get this answer. Okay. So what is A cube? Now 27. 27 is which cube? 27. If you write 3 cube. 3 3 is a 9. 9 3 is a 27. So it is 3 cube. So 27 is nothing but 3 cube, and p cube is also there. Together 3 and p is together all cube. When you do 3p into 3p into 3p, cube it, you will get 27p cube. Then minus, now b cube I should write. Now 216 is there, which cube we have to find. So 216 is nothing but 6 cube. You can check it, yes or no, it is 6 into 6 into 6. 6, 6 are 36. 36 into 6. 6, 6 are 36, 3 in hand, 6, 3 is 18 plus 3, 21. So you will get 216. It is nothing but 216 only you will get. So it is 6 cube. So I will write 1 is 1 cube. If you get 1 cube, you'll get 1. But 216 is nothing but you have to take a 6, it's a cube. So it is 1 by 6, since it is in the denominator, 1 by 6 you have to take, it's a cube. A cube minus b cube minus 3ab, 3 into, or you can write in this format, you can get the same answer. 3ab. A is how much? 3ab. A is 3p. If you want, you can write. So we have now A as 3p. And in B place, B cube. B is which one? B now? B is 1 by 6. Now I will write 3ab. Or you can write this or this, both you can write, or if you want to write like this way, you can write it. Okay, 3 a is how much? 3p by b is 1 by 6 into a minus b, a is 3p minus b is 1 by 6. Or if you simplify to get this answer, so it is nothing but 3p cube minus 1 by 6 cube minus, if you multiply this, if you see here, 3 threes are 9, you can cancel here, okay. 3 ones are 3, 2s are. So it is 3 into 3, 9 into p, 9p by 2, 9 by 2 and p into p, p square. Again you will get the same answer, here you will get 9 by 2 p square. If you write it in this form, you will get 9 by 2 p square only you will get. Okay. Same thing. A cube minus b cube minus 3a square b only will get. Minus 3a square is how much? Minus 3, 3 is 9 p square by 2. Plus, we'll check it whether we will get it. 1s are 3. 2, 6 are 12. So, 3 by 12. And 1 p is there. P. Or if you simplify, 3 1s are 3 4s. How much you will get? 1 by 4 p. See, you will get same 1 by 4. So, now a cube, b cube minus 3 a square b plus 3 ab square. So, how much you will get? Or if you want to write this only, 3 a square b. That's it. So, it is nothing but a cube minus a minus b cube. A is how much? 3p, 3, where it is, a, 3p minus b is how much? 1 by 6, it's a cube. So we can do like this way. Now, see the next problem. You have to prove something. You have to verify the question and answer they are given. Ninth problem. Verify. First one. X cube plus Y cube is equal to X plus Y into x square minus xy plus y square. Now here in such problems, when answer is given, when you do x cube plus y cube, you will get this answer, x plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. Show that, prove that, verify. In such problem, question is also given, answer is also given. In the equation form, they will give. Now, what we have to do now, if answer is given? Our work is, there are different methods are there. First, one method is, you can take only left-hand side and you have to use some mathematical aspects and you have to simplify to get this aspect. That is one method. Or you can take the right hand side of the equal sign, this part, xy into x square minus xy plus y square. Simplify this doing proper mathematical aspects and at last you have to get the answer, this particular, then also you can prove it. Or another method is, you can take both left hand side and right hand side equation, simplify so that both side, this side and this side answer should come same. That is another method. Or entirely you can take different related formula and change it properly so that you will get this result. So whichever manner we can do. Now I will use the identity just now which we have studied, a plus b whole cube, that identity. In that one cube will come, a cube and b cube will come. So I will use that identity and I will properly change the places of the terms so that I will get this particular aspect. By that I will verify this result. Okay. Now what is the identity I am going to use is, this identity I am going to use, that is a plus b, this identity only I know, I don't know anything about it. So I will use this one, a plus b whole cube is ए क्यूब प्लस बी क्यूब प्लस थ्री ए ए बी इंटू ए प्लस बी. दिस आइडेंटिटी आई विल यूज फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम. ओके नाउ व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम इज गिवन x and y, not a and b. So I will take now x and y instead of a and b, okay, because they all terms are in x and y. So x plus y qy will do. Okay, then what I will get according to this identity, it is x cube plus y cube plus 3 into a. Now in this problem, a place I have x and b place I have y. Okay, so easily we can do a cube plus b cube, then 3ab. Instead of ab, what I should do? X into y, xy, then into a plus b. A plus b, we have to write in the problem, it is x plus y. This is the formula I know, right? Now, I want only x cube plus y cube, right? I want x cube and y cube. So what I will do is I will bring all these terms to this left hand side. What I will get, already x plus y whole cube is there. Now I will bring this plus this full term, this particular term, I will bring to the left hand side of the equal sign. Okay, so the plus will change into minus. You know the rule, when you shift the terms from left hand to right hand or right hand to left hand, the sign will change. Plus will change into, addition will change into minus, minus sign will change into plus, into operation will change into divide, and divide operation change into. So here it is plus sign, so it will change into minus 3xy into x. Only this sign will change, the starting, this won't change, okay, because this is the sign. Plus we are doing this particular term, so this particular term we have to do subtraction, okay, so this sign will be as it is. So what left out here, because I want only x cube plus y cube, so I will keep that only on the other side. Now I have to simplify this to get this answer, okay. Now if you observe this term, this term and this term, which term is common in both these terms? First term, this is the second term, which term is common in these two terms? If you observe carefully, x plus y cube is there, and here also one x plus y is present. Okay, so in these two terms, I have x plus y, this particular term is common in both the terms, this binomial. So what is left out? X plus y cube is there, that is x plus y into x plus y into x plus y, three terms. Out of that one term, x plus y multiplication, I have brought it, this particular term, one term outside. So how much x plus y remaining to multiply? It is x plus y into x plus y, two times. So it is x plus y whole square, because one x plus y is brought outside to multiply, minus 3xy, and here only one x plus y is there, that and x plus y is brought outside, so nothing is there, only one is remaining, so 1 into 3xy is that number only, this is left out, okay. This I won't change, right, as it is, x cube plus y cube, okay. Now don't touch it, because one answer I want is one, don't do anything, keep as it is, x plus y. And here, this bracket I will change. Now, I know the formula, x plus y whole square. A plus b whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square, right? So, I will use this one now. X a square. A square is x square plus 2ab. 2ab xy plus b square. B square, b is y here. So, it is y square. X plus y whole square is x square plus 2xy plus y square. Then this term I have to write without change, minus 3xy, and don't do anything, write as it is, x cube plus y cube. Now it is x plus y, write as it is. Now we will write in the simplified form, in this form. X square is there first, x square. Now here, if you observe carefully, the like terms are present here. xy, this is also xy. So xy term is common here. There are two, not common, there are two terms, xy term is there, like terms are there. I will simplify, I will write together. So it is plus 2xy, it is minus 3xy. Plus 2xy, then minus 3xy. So both are xy. Since they have different sign, you cannot add it. You have to find the difference. If the sign is different for like terms, you have to find the difference. So what is the difference of 3 and 2? 1 it is. 1 usually we won't write. Let it by write 1 now. And what is the unlike term? Like term, that is xy. 3xy and minus 3xy plus 2xy. If you add, you will get 1xy. And bigger number sign you will get. Bigger number is here 3. So its sign is minus. So you will get minus. And usually 1 we are not writing in the algebraic terms. So it is minus xy if you do this operation. Okay. So it is minus xy. If you do this and this simplification. And y square is left out. I will write now y square. It's nothing but x cube plus y cube. So that is the answer which I needed. X cube, this side it is there, no problem. Right hand side or left hand side. X cube plus y cube is equal to x plus y. X plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. I got the answer. So in this way, I have shown the answer taking the different, means taking the identity without taking directly the answer. I simplified and at last I got the result which they are given. So in this way I verified the answer. So this is the one of the method you can prove it. Understood? So take the identity, this identity, and properly bring the terms and simplify accordingly to get this result. So that is the way we can prove. Will you try, children, along with me the next second problem, x cube minus y cube in the same manner? Will you try now? So along with me, you try. I will also work out on the blackboard. You also work out in your book. There is second problem. What is the second problem? Verify x cube minus y cube, I think. X cube minus y cube. X cube minus y cube is equal to. X cube minus y cube is equal to x minus y. And here x square plus xy plus y square. This is the thing we have to verify. Here which identity we should take similar to that first one? Here minus sign is there. So which identity is suitable here? It is a minus b whole cube is equal to a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. This identity I have to use to get that result. Second problem. Now, instead of a and b, I have in the problem x and y. So I will take x minus y cube is equal to, so accordingly a here, a is x, b and y. Here a cube I have to write, a is x, so x cube, minus sign is there, right minus. Then b cube, b is here y, so y cube minus 3 into a into b. 3 into a is x into x into y is xy. 3xy into a minus b. A is x minus b is y. This is the identity using x and y I wrote. Now I will keep this one side because I want x cube minus y cube. Bring this last term, the left hand side of the equal sign. So what is already present here? X minus y cube. I'll write little this side to give the place. I'll write x minus y cube. It is already present in the left hand side. Now I am bringing the minus term. So minus term will change into plus. Only this is the full single term if you imagine. Only this sign, one sign will change. this sign will not change, okay? So it is minus will change into plus 3xy into x minus y. So if we bring this side equals, now what is left out here? X cube minus y cube, right? Now simplification. Again, similar to first problem, there is one common term is present in these two terms. Which is the common factor? It is x minus y cube, three times multiplied, and x minus y is present here in the second term. This first term, this is the second term. That common term, I'll keep it outside the bracket, x minus y, and inside the bracket, x minus y, three times multiplied, one time took outside. So two times x minus y is multiplied is present. Plus sign 3xy, since this term is taken outside, it is nothing left out to write along with this. This write as it is now x cube minus y cube. Now I will use a minus b whole square formula. What is a minus b whole square formula? It is a square minus 2ab plus b square, right? Now a square, a is x, here I have written a is x, so x square minus 2ab, minus 2ab, in place of ab I should write xy, xy plus b square in place of b I should write y square. So this particular term, when you simplify, you will get this answer. And this term is there, that you have to write without fail. So all terms I wrote. Then here, right hand side, only x cube minus y cube is there, write as it is without changing. Now write x minus y into, now I will simplify because there are two terms which are like terms, xy, here also xy. So what two terms I have? Minus 2xy plus 3xy. Here xy term, both have common term xy, so you can do the simplification. Since they have different sign, you have to find the difference. So 3 and 2 difference is 1xy is equal to, and bigger number is 3, its sign is plus, so plus will come. Plus usually we won't write in the term, and 1 also we won't write, so it is xy, okay? So what left out? X square write as it is. When you simplify these two terms, I will get a plus xy and plus y square. And here as it is x cube minus y cube. So this is the required answer I proved. This is the required answer. Only place is changed, left and right, no problem. So x cube minus y cube is equal to x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square. Okay. So actually, this is the new identity. In some problems, they will give you, which is originated from the identity a plus b cube or a minus b cube. So in the list of the identity, you can add these two verified answers to use it for some other next problem. You have to use this one. So which is the identity we have learned, which is obtained from the identity a plus b whole cube. So the identity, it is a cube plus b cube. There we proved x cube plus y cube, but the identity we can write it separately. You write it like identity a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b into a square minus, that you have to remember, minus here, even the plus is there in the answer, it will come minus ab, not 2ab, ab it is, plus b square. It almost looks like a square minus 2ab plus b square, but 2 is not there, remember, okay? Then second identity you have to remember, using that original a minus b whole cube, you will get this one, a cube minus b cube, it is minus sign is there, a minus b is the first factor, and second factor is same like this one, a square is there, ab is there, and b square is there, but one difference is all is plus, this also plus, here also plus. So this is the two identity. Some problem they will give to solve the problems using this identity. Okay. So that is the next problem. If you check out the 10th problem, factorize each of the following. There are two problems. 10th one, factorize. This when you they have given a cube plus b cube, to find this one, it is called factorize. Okay, factorize each of the following. First one, 27. First one, 27 y cube minus, not minus, plus 125 z cube. Now it is in the form of a cube plus b cube. It is cube, it is also cube. So to get the factors, this is one factor, a plus b, and second factor is a square minus ab plus b square. So this one reduce into a cube plus b cube. You should know which is a and which is b, then you can write the factors easily. So I will write it in the cube form. This is nothing but equals 27 is which cube? 27 can be written as 3 cube. Right, so it is 3 and y cube is also there, so together 3y, it's a cube, plus 125 is which cube? 5 cube. 5 5 is 9, 5 5 is 25, 25 5 is 125. Here 3 3 is 9, 9 3 is 27, so it is 5z cube. If I wrote a cube plus b cube, then the answer is, the factors are a plus b. One factor is a plus b. The second factor is a square minus ab plus b square. So the first factor is a plus b. Here a is 3y and b is 5z. So the first factor is a plus b. A is how much? A is 3y, a plus b, b is 5z. This is the first factor, and the second factor is a square. A is 3y, its whole square, minus a into b. A is 3y and b is 5z. AB plus b square, b is how much? 5z. 5z whole square. So this is the second factor. So if you simplify, write as it is 3y plus 5z, one factor. Second factor, we will write the simplified form, 3y square. 3y square is 3y into 3y, 3 3s are 9, y into y square. So it is 9y square minus 3 5s are 15, y into z, plus 5z whole square. It is 5z into 5z is equal to 5 5s are 25, z into z square. It is 25z square. This is the last answer. So one factor is 3y plus 5z, 27y cube plus 125z cube is one factor is 3y plus 5z, and next factor is 9y square minus 15yz plus 25. This is the answer, children. You try the second problem at home today. Okay? Thank you.